everybody, welcome back to Dhatu Yoga with me, Shubha. And I had been getting a lot of requests from the beautiful audiences asking for telling the procedure or simple procedures this practiced on daily basis will help us to activate this pineal gland, which is also called as the third eye chakra. So we'll discuss and dive in deep and understand some basic things what to be doing on daily basis to help it activate. If you like this video, definitely please hit the like button. If you're new and not yet subscribed, kindly please subscribe to the channel. All your valuable comments, queries are always welcome. Let's get started here and understand how do we do this procedure of activating this important chakra which is present in our body. Within our own body, it is present. So we have been hearing, right? Third eye. Also Shivji, it's told in Puranas and all, you know, Shivji has the third eye. He opened the third eye. All that is there. But before understanding what is the third eye, we'll slowly enter into the third eye things. There are two eyes which we can literally see, a physical manifested things throughout surrounding. All the things which are physically manifested, we can see. But the third eye sees something beyond the physical manifested things. This we know. So it is the pineal gland. And that secretes a hormone called as melatonin. And this hormone helps in proper circulation of, you know, cardiovascular tissues. Circulation of blood in that area. And also it is produces hormones for reproduction. Also, that is the only hormone which helps in proper sleep and awakening things daily in our life. Because when we are awake, there are certain hormones which are secreted. When we are asleep, there are certain hormones which are essential for our body, which we know, don't know, it's in that state. Because literally, actually, once there is a sunset, it's time that we take rest, actually, ideally speaking. But this doesn't support our lifestyle. That's why we can see there is a lot of issues with respect to reproductive issues, cardiovascular disorders. No proper clarity, because the third eye gives us clarity, visibility. Ultimate knowledge is gone through the third eye. Because these two eyes can only see the physical manifested things and whatever data it collects, that kind of visibility it gets. But to see the things as it is, too perfectly and clearly the way it is, we need the third eye chakra. Every one of us have this within us, and there are some simple 5 steps I would like to share through which we can definitely try our best, because everybody have our own limitations and possibilities because of our own karmic things. And these are the things, so it is well versed when it is practiced under a guru. But in our own best way, whatever we can practice in our daily basis, if we do these steps, we can do our best, be our best version. Because all of us, we can try being our best version, whatever we can do. So first and foremost, I would say that switch to a sattvic food order. If you are planning or looking for some rajasic meat, eating fish, all that, slowly reduce it and then cut down and just please shift to the sattvic food. Ideally speaking, fruits, vegetables, milk products have to be consumed in large amount, especially before going to bed and all, you know, consuming of milk with turmeric and eating fruits, vegetables and sleeping. It's ideal. Not stuffing ourselves with, you know, because whenever, what is non-veg food? They take an animal, which is also a living being, they chop it and the animal will die out of fear, and that fear hormones are secreted in the body and that same flush is there and it is sold and we consume it and the same hormones are, you know, it doesn't blend. This is the first step one has to follow if really we are interested in, you know, to get the clarity, because switching off the food style is very, very, very essential, because it is also affects our way of thinking, our thought process, hormones which are secreted in the body. It has a lot of effect. And the second one would be that you get exposed to the sunlight during the daytime, especially during the early morning, as soon as the sun rises. How many of us have seen the sunrise? Ideally, we wake up after the sunrise. Sometimes we wake up after 12 o'clock. Weekends, right? It is. So I sleep and, you know, 12 o'clock, sunlight is falling on my head, forehead, then I wake up. So I'm very sorry to tell that the first rays of sunlight is very, very, very auspicious for us. And that sunlight, if we get absorbed in it, and the body gets refreshing energy, no doubt. And the third point would be that we take up some practices of meditation. This is very, very important. That people were asking me, what is the importance of lighting a diya, especially evening lighting a diya and sitting in front of it? Because these kind of lights, you know, they reduce the energy levels within us. But the natural diya, whatever we lit with a lamp, you know, ghee lamp or with oil, and sit facing towards east, especially, okay, and then close our eyes and watch, or at least watch the diya for some time, the diya whichever we have lit. Also, the practice of jyoti trataka is there in yogic practices, which is excellent, because in our head we be thinking, right, oh, we fought with the person, because only this limited two eyes will give us the perspective of I am right, you're wrong, you're right, I am wrong, the conflicts. Usually the daily conflicts are there, definitely, especially at home or at office with your colleagues, friends, family, neighbors, in general with whomever we react or interact. So there's a tendency that I am right, you are wrong. Usually that's when the conflict arises. So once you take up some practices of jyoti trataka, gazing at a light, flame, you know, candlelight, or very important. That is the significance of lighting a diya in the evenings and sitting down some minutes peacefully. Why have this ancient practices were there? Were they fools to practice all this? They were brilliant masters. We become a very IT-driven, intellectual-driven world. My God, very talented people we are. The results can be directly seen, how talented we are and how the great yogis have led their life. So this is one of the very, very, very good practice, and also sitting in meditation in Padmasana and concentrating on your third eye. So basically there are two halves, right? The left half of the brain, right half of the brain, all this. So Shiva Shakti combination. If one left side is very active, then it is Shakti Swarupini. If the right is active, then it is Shiva's energy. So somewhere in between it is balanced, means then we are activating the third eye. So this manifestation has taken place with both yin and yang, both Shiva Shakti. So we balance it out, that energy, and move ahead. And then only we become people with hyperactivities, hypertension, all that will reduce. The secretion of this hormone called melatonin helps us to stabilize the hypertension activities which we undergo daily basis. That is the reason people tell to take up meditation morning, evening. Evening meditation is excellent. Sunset, dark time meditation. No room is kept dark and we lit a diya. This is called jyoti trataka. There are procedure for jyoti trataka to practice. After doing jyoti trataka, most of all, I would say 100% actually, that whatever conflicts you had taken up in your past, whatever things you have fought or had misconceptions, some agony, frustration, anger, agitation, whatever you had against anyone, all that you start feeling it was silly. This has worked out practically, and this is the thing which one has to practice. Meditation, sitting down. meditation, more than meditation, Jyoti Trataka definitely, and Jatru Trataka. Best practices they are. And definitely practice of yoga, daily basis. This is very, 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 very important. It keeps us active and makes us understanding that what exactly one has to do. Okay, because the hormones, proper balancing is happening inside us, and it literally keeps us calm. Only a calm mind, whenever we have a calm mind, only then only we can see things as it is, right? Simple, like, you know, a weighing machine. Already when you hold it, it's not properly stabilized. Now you try weighing it. Definitely that weight will be incorrect. Similarly, like us, when our vision is distorted or we are having some own half information or whatever, we are able to see that much, we take it and start analyzing things and taking conclusions over it. That will be incorrect conclusions. That is when, have we seen people that after taking certain conclusion, after certain period of time, they repent for their own conclusion, suffer. So this is how it is. Only when a steady mind, only when we are happy, we can look out in solving any problem, right? When we are only not happy, we are only having our own distorted issues within our own self, how can we solve somebody's problem? Or something as a boss maybe at work, or even as a work person, we colleague, a routine work, how can we solve anything? Or even at home, if there are some issues, our distorted visions can't solve. We feel that we are only right, the other party is always wrong. That is the base of all the conflicts. So this is how we'll have to be. There is an importance of space element, you know, that is because the overall cosmos, there is only space which is existing. Planets are very tiny manifestation. Even the galaxies, for that matter, are very tiny manifestation in the overall Brahmanda, the space. The space is the ultimate. And the manifestation, whatever physically some things have happened, is a very minutest thing. So we are just looking at that minutest thing and telling that is right. But the space is the ultimate truth. That is the reason of meditation. It hits that ultimate clarity. It hits the pineal gland, which is very, very important for us. This is how we'll have to be looking at how do we do things. What is the importance of pineal gland? Because we know, right, in our daily basis, the conclusions, whatever we draw out of certain issues, certain decision making, will give us a lot of trauma, suffering, agitation, frustration. All this is there. Waking up early during Brahma Muhurat and taking a meditation, or in the evening, as soon as the sunset, doing the meditation with lighting a diya. Very, very important. You can gaze at a diya. Keep it at your eye level, or you only distance yourself. Look at a diya. Or close your eyes. Just lift your cheek little up. Close your eyes. Or rolling your eyes upward. Closing your eyes and rolling your eyes upwards will help you to look for a higher dimension. Because these two eyes can only see a lower dimension things. We have a dimension which is beyond this physical manifestation. Definitely, yes. There is Rahu Ketu, which is not physically manifested. But we say there is Rahu Ketu now. Who has seen Rahu Ketu? So there is some other dimension. We have to touch that dimension. That is when we get a clarity. We thought this body, this mind is the ultimate truth. Right? So the light which you are looking out is definitely in the form of this third eye chakra. Just lit this within you and let you glow forever. If you like this video, kindly please hit the like button. If you are new and not yet subscribed, kindly please subscribe to the channel. All your valuable comments, queries are always welcome. That's all for today. Take care. Namaste. Bye.